How's it going?
You're good.
Hi, I'm James Springett. I'm 33, from East Worthing, and I'm a gardener. I think I've been hooked on Bravas for near on 33 years now, actually, yeah. As soon as I came out, first thing my mum gave me was Bravas. I drank aioli instead of milk, and bathed in spicy tomato sauce. The thing I look for most in Bravas is definitely crunchy texture and a really strong garlic aioli. I'd best describe my Bravas as very authentic. From a little back street, maybe a bar in Barcelona somewhere, one that's not really, not that well heard of. But in Barcelona, definitely well heard of. You know, everybody knows it. Techniques and ingredients. I mean, the main special ingredient for me is definitely MSG. As far as techniques, you know, I've tried them all out over the week. Since Sunday, I've had Bravas every single night. And I think I've finally found the one that's going to win this competition for me. Everyone's going to be really good. Bar Cameron Springett, I mean, I don't know. I've seen him cook once before. And he made a stir fry using kiwi fruit and banana and rice. So, yeah, I don't think so. Maybe Tony. I think Tony did more. He's I think he would have been practicing just as hard.
Couple of brusques.
I keep shaving my fingernails as well. Potato peeler.
Uno tactics would probably just be to make up the rules as I go along and, maybe hide some cards in my little yellow pocket that I've got here. Yeah, that could work well.
One with the King Edward potato. After trying all of them, including jacket potatoes, just your classic salad potatoes, this is definitely the best one.
Yeah, I tried lots of different potatoes over the week and, even thinking of doing some
sweet potato Bravas.
Sweet potato Bravas. 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 Bravas.
I don't think I'm worried about James and his Bravas. I mean, I've seen the potatoes. He's got a sweet potato in there. I don't think he knows what he's doing.
I am worried about James as a contender because I know he's a good cook and I know he likes to get shit done properly.
I just don't feel like it's going to happen tonight. Put the groundwork in, but I've just got this feeling that when it comes down to it, the Bravas just ain't going to be what it should be.
I'm not worried about James.
I've got a funny story about James.
There was this one time that he got really drunk.
He got absolutely hammered.
James had a few sherbets.
Sneezy drunk. Really drunk.
Got, like, well too drunk.
And fell asleep at Timmy and John's.
Somehow he managed to... We don't really know what happened, but...
Little naughty sleepwalking.
I like to think he was sleepwalking.
And he obviously sleptwalked.
Supposedly sleptwalked.
All the way outside. Downstairs. Outside the block of flats.
In his boxer shorts.
The police arrived.
He got woken up. Apparently he was just wearing a little mustard t-shirt and some boxer shorts.
And they put him in the back of the car and stuff. And that's when he sort of came round and had sort of like no recollection of what was actually going on.
And that's why James is no longer allowed within 500 feet of Hove Station.
Getting the cab coming, can you do X, Y, Z? Like,
sorry to interrupt you. can I take yours?
Oh, sorry, Al.
Sorry, I'm one of the difficult. I'm a vegan.
Oh, don't worry about it. The menu's vegan.
Oh, great. Right. Oh,
yes,
yeah,
right. Yes. Morgan, what can I get you?
I think I'll have the Bravas.
Good choice.
And just some olives.
Well, I'll try. I'll try.
Does the B stand for Bravas?
Does.
I'll have some Bravas then, please.
Lovely.
Cheers, mate.
You want?
The only thing on here is Bravas.
Well, you might as well have that.
Yeah, I'll have the San Arb. The San Arb.
Yeah, that's Bravas actually in Casablanca.
Thank you. Okay.
It's the crispiest and the driest of all the oils. Even though it seems liquid, but it's actually not. It's pure crisp when you pour it out.
Yeah.
So I'm gonna let that heat up, you know, to about super hot. Then plop the potatoes in. Fuck, there's a hair on that one.
Should that be boiling like a deep fat fryer?
No.
No, just going for the slow boil.
Slow boil.
Fuck! I think I've got too much potato in there.
Using this.
Nah, no, mate.
I've never had my own individual Bravas before, to be fair. Normally,
Oh shit, that has a lot of sauce.
Is it?
I'm getting that. Not that alley-oly.
It's amazing. It does look good.
I'm not worried, but there were elements of this which were really, really quite high end.
Well, yeah, the alioli sauce.
The alioli was the star of the show.
That was amazing. There was like little Bravas compared to sauce, but then he brought out that whole other like extra bowl of Bravas, which I wasn't expecting, which sort of made it like a bit better. But as far as taste goes, like, the actual Bravas sauce for me wasn't spicy enough.
The red sauce wasn't spicy enough. For me, I thought the sweet potato, I applaud experimentation in every aspect of life. However, with experimentation comes risk. And for me, I felt like it was a risk which didn't pay off.
Well, I don't think it did either, because they were soggy as fuck.
They were,
you know what I mean?
They were soggy, and there's no room for sogginess in the Bravas world. But what I did enjoy was eating them off the fucking oven.
That was good.
Which was a touch.
Yeah.
I'm still waiting for those olives.
Yeah.
That's the main talking point for me, was the choice of sweet potato.
Yeah, I actually thought that was quite good, and it wasn't as soggy as
I thought. Yeah, I wasn't a fan for the Bravas.
No, but I could see the oil wasn't hot. I was like, ooh, this is going to be soggy potato, but there was some crispy ones in there.
I think overall red sauce was below average.
Yeah.
Way below average.
Yeah.
White sauce probably did last of that what I made before.
You can.
Yeah, pretty well. If I determine things on the hand that I've just got in Uno, we're looking at a switchback. We've got a couple of sevens, we've got a couple of plus twos. And just put Joe Walker on. So overall, I'm going for a sturdy 8.5 for an evening. Thank you.
Of course, it doesn't matter.
Stop my dick, motherfucker!
Like, some of it was crispy as fuck and well nice, and I was like, this could be fucking amazing. But then other bits were not crispy enough, too soft. And I actually really like this sweet potato, which I was surprised by. I thought I wouldn't like it. Save the biggest letdown for me was probably the Bravas sauce, which was not spicy enough. It was below average. I really like the aioli in terms of the quantity, not enough for me. I enjoyed it once the big bowl got taken out, but then obviously that was like a free for all and it was quite soggy. That stuff was like the second best. I'd probably go a 7.5. I think the best that I could offer that one. Although I had a fucking struggle. Thank you.
So, my initial worry or concern was about the sweet potato involved in the Bravas, which I must say was not to my favour. You know, but I must say the other Bravas was a good quality. It was crispy, it was nice. The sweet potato was just not my agreeable. The aioli sauce was exceptional, plus vegan. Well done, James. Red sauce, however, was say below par. Even when you brought out the second batch, I'd say it was not up to scratch. And apart from the Bravas, the evening was amazing. You set the tone. Spanish flags, lots of beer. So I think overall I'm gonna say James's Bravas evening gets 7.5 out of 10. Good night.
So I thought tonight was really, really good. I thought that aioli was really, really strong, really garlicky. The sweet potato, you try fucking playing it outside the fucking ring. I felt like it didn't pay off in its favour because they went a bit fucking like mushy and shit. But overall, like, it was a good effort. And he had beers.
I think overall, I'm going to give him a 7.
Springett's done a really good job this evening. I'm giving his Bravas a 7 out of 10. I think the effort he went to with the flags and the placemats and the menus and the Spanish vibe was really strong. The atmosphere was amazing, everyone had a really good time. The booze was flying, the booze was Spanish as well, that was really good. If I had to have any kind of criticism, it would be that the sweet potato went mushy in amongst the Bravas. But the high point, without a doubt, was the aioli, which was really fucking good. Thank you.